Hello everyone, this is Pooja Maurya. Today we are going to start our class 10 biology, and many of the students face difficulty in science, some in the physics section, some in the chemistry section, and some in the bio section. So today here we are to make their concept very clear about the biology section. In our bio section, we are having 6 chapters. First chapter is the life process, second is control and coordination, third is how do we reproduce, fourth one is the heredity and evolution, our fifth chapter is our environment, and our sixth chapter, last but not the least, is the management of natural resources. So here we are introducing these chapters just to make you clear your concepts and whatever the doubts you have, so that you can remember the technical terms and the concept involved in these six chapters. So this channel is to help you to clear your board exams and to score good marks. And 10th class is the very basic class, and this is the first step towards your career, in where you are having you are starting your board classes and board exams. So in the life process chapter, we are actually dealing with the processes involved in our life, that is like the digestion, circulation, excretion, how the digestion takes place and how circulation is going on in our body, how excretion takes place and why this process is important, from where does we get this energy to complete these all processes. This will deal with the life process and how our body is maintaining the coordination, and how the brain is controlling our body functions and hormones are controlling. We will see in the second chapter. How do we reproduce? Reproduction is also a life process, but here in this chapter we will deal with the processes and the basic functions of the system involved and the organs involved. Reproduction in plants, reproduction in animals, and what is the difference between sexual reproduction, asexual reproduction, this we will deal in this chapter. Fourth chapter is heredity and evolution. In this chapter we will study how the genes transfer from our parents to the offspring. From parents to the offspring, and how the humans evolved, or how the bacteria evolved, and how the evolution takes place to make the organism fit to adapt to the environment. And our environment is the chapter we will basically dealing with our environment, what all components we have in the environment, biotic components, abiotic components, and how these components are interacting with each other, and how the food chain is comprising, and how food web is happening in the environment, and how the energy transfer takes place. This all we will deal in this chapter, our environment. Last but not the least is the management of natural resources. In this, we will learn about the natural resources like air, water, land and soil, and how we manage these resources. Because management of everything is very important. If we are not managing our strategy, or if we are not managing our whole syllabus, that also will not be good for our exams and to score good marks. So management of natural resources is the important chapter, because this deals with the basically the management, that is of the how to manage our air, not to get it polluted, and how to manage water, how to conserve water, like water harvesting, and to what is the function of dam, and what is the function of soil, forest. This all we will see in this chapter, management of natural resources. So this is the basically the introduction class, and in the next chapter, in the next video, I will make the life process chapter and the basic concepts involved, and I will also share and I will also discuss the questions asked in CBSE.